Hello everybody, I am Ashima here with all of you. I am here to conduct the virtual classes for class 3 and 4, subject English. So, the videos will be different for class 3 and 4, but this is the introductory video. I will be giving you some common topics to write on, so both the class 3 and 4 students can come use this video as a reference. So, today we will be discussing about the writing skills. I will be giving you a topic to write on. Before that, I will let you know how to write effectively. You all are good writers, I know. You will write very well on any given topic. But to write effectively, we have some key points to keep in mind. So before discussing that, I would like to move on to the slides. Let's move on to the slides. So today's topic for the virtual class, as you will know, is writing skills or how to write creatively or effectively. So I'll be telling you some key points to keep in mind whenever you're writing. In this lockdown period when we are with the family, all the time we should not be on the phones or the television is the only source. You should indulge yourself in some creative work. Meanwhile, I want to be involved in your next session also, the next session your class 4 and class 3 students. So I want to involve you more in creative writing. I'll be giving you a topic soon. So before that, you should be knowing what are the steps of creative writing or effective writing. The first, as you will very well see on this slide, is brainstorm. Brainstorm simply means when you just heard the word, the topic, whatever I will give you. So whenever it just strike your mind and the brainstorming session starts, you just start compiling your thoughts, the visuals, whatever you have seen or heard about the topic. Then second step is main idea, that the topic belongs to what? What is the basic reason we are writing on it? Then detail 1, 2, 3, write the first detail, second detail, third detail, and the detail so far, whatever you know, just collect the data from surroundings, from the social media, from the internet, from your parents, from your friends, or from the books or the newspaper, and just write on it. It should be very effective. Writing skills doesn't seem like to write, to focus on your handwriting. It focuses to write the right content. Then we have the sixth step, that is conclusion. Conclusion is basically the synonym for result or the outcome. That after all the details and data you have given, you have to be on a conclusion, a solid conclusion, that whatever you have written is in this conclusion. Then the seventh point is to edit it. Just look at it, your writing section, your writing portion. You have to focus on your spellings, your grammatical errors, your sentence formation, and just look at it all around and just correct it, edit it, and then present it forward. So now after this writing session, for effective writing on any given topic, you just have to brainstorm around these six words, the question words you basically know, and in between there is a question mark that will be your given topic. I'll be announcing soon what you have to write on. So these are the basic question words. When you brainstorm on it, us topic se related jawab is in questions ko answer karenge, you will be getting your more and more data to write on. So for example, who, the topic is related to whom, who is it affected to, kisko affect kar raha hai wo, who is affected by that phenomena if it is a process, or agar aap kisi picture ya kisi aur reality thing ke liye likhe to who was there involved, ki kaun kaun wahan tha. So who is basically that category. Then what means kya ho raha hai wahan par, if it is a real scene or the scene from your past, like a zoo trip, like a circus trip, like what happened last Sunday when I was on outing with my family. So us time kya kya hua, that includes in this category. Where, kahan par hua wo event, why, as you very well know, why means kyun kiya gaya, if it is a real life phenomena to kyun hua, it is just a simple reason, you can define it why it happened. Or if it is not there, just skip this point. Then how it is affecting or how it happened actually, ki wo kaise hua wo kaam, and then when, kab. So jab ye sab mil jayenge, when it gets all together, you will be getting your all of the data you have to write in your writing section. So the one thing that is very important for you kids to write, like elders can write anything, like they have so many information through different sources, but you guys, you small kids need to have some clues. कि हमें किस you should be having some hint words, some keywords basically. Keywords से आप sentences जोड़ जोड़ के बना सकते हैं. I'll be giving you some basic keywords कि आपको किस किस keyword को कैसे use करना है first, second, third, ताकि आपका जो writing section है it will become more effective and I would say it will be a more accurate one. So let us move on to the keywords. Ready? Okay. Before moving on to the keywords I'll give you later on, you must be knowing the ongoing topic which is all over there around the news channels, the social media, WhatsApps and everywhere. We are talking about at homes also, that is COVID-19. We are all suffering from it. Just not because we are not infected, we are not suffering. We are actually suffering because we everything is locked down now. We are at homes, we cannot go out, we cannot go shopping, we cannot go to the classes, we cannot attend the school even. So this is COVID-19, this is your topic to write on. The basic things, the keywords I provide you, but the basic thing you can see on the slide, that is novel coronavirus. COVID-19, very well known, is originated basically from Wuhan, that is a place in China. So you must be knowing the preventions, the symptoms. The symptoms are basic like a flu, a common flu, that is fever, cough, difficulty in breathing, muscle pain and tiredness, just like a common flu. But it spreads from person to person. So the preventions are avoid contact with the sick people, wash your hands with soap and water. If you develop cough, use a medical face mask. These are the basic preventions. So many other preventions we have to take, like using our elbow for coughing. Do not open the tap directly by your hands. Transmission days, it spreads through the droplets when we cough or sneeze. And it takes 2 to 14 days to show the symptoms. So it is not easily detected. And if detected, we have to be isolated for few days or we have to self-quarantine. These are the basic words actually you will be seeing in the keyword session. So let us now move on to the keyword slide.
Yeah.
So here is our keyword slide. I'll be providing you some basic keywords you can use to write, make your writing section more effective about COVID-19. The basic one is Wuhan, the origination point, the epicenter of COVID-19 that is originated in, that is located in China. COVID-19 wet market. It basically, as we came to know from the social media and WhatsApp videos, like they just say it started from wet market. The basic symptoms are cough, sneezing. Social distancing is the only cure that the government is just applying on us. Sanitization, stay home. Pandemic is another word you can use. Pandemic means the fatal disease which causes a loss of life at a larger scale in the world. Quarantine is another word which means to stay isolated or away from people. It can be, quarantine comes from a word which means to stay away for 40 days. So you can use this word again and again. Lockdown period is the most important one because we are going through the lockdown period. It is of 21 days. It can be extended if it doesn't control, if it could not be controlled by us. Vaccine. COVID-19 vaccine is not yet developed. The various associations are trying to develop a vaccine for COVID-19. Okay, so vaccine is the keyword that you'll be using. Like, no, we have not developed the COVID-19 vaccine yet. Every country is trying to do that. Then the next one is wash hands frequently. That has been told to you again and again, again and again. It should be for 20 seconds with the soap. You should be doing it because it spreads through the droplets when we cough and sneeze. And we should not use our hands more for coughing and sneezing. Then the next one is, and the last one is mask. We should wear a mask if we feel like coughing and sneezing, but it should be properly worn and it should be disposed effectively so that it cannot affect the other people if it comes in contact. So these are the basic keywords like Wuhan, quarantine, lockdown, sneezing, cough, social distancing. These are all we are hearing every time in the news channels, on the WhatsApp groups, like social media. Everywhere these words are used. So you can combine all these, make your effective sentences and come up with your effective writing. So next I will be giving you the homework, your assignment.
So your homework for this virtual session, class 3 and 4 combined, let me be very clear, I'll be giving videos for class 3 and 4 separately from the next time, but this would be a common assignment. All of you have to write a paragraph of about 100 to 150 words on the topic COVID-19, the pandemic. I have used the word pandemic, it was in the keywords also, just to be more clear with the situation that what we are going through. Usme aap kuch bhi addition kar sakte. You can add on your feelings, what are you feeling at home right now, what are your plans for next 20 or 90, 21 days of lockdown, what you are doing creatively. It should not take more than an hour to be sitting with your parents and discussing about it and collecting all the information. This would be your homework, and I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye.